All right, so welcome back. In the previous video, we set up all the components that we need for our playable character here inside of our character blueprint. We assigned our camera, we assigned our skeletal mesh for the visual representation of our character. We also made some adjustments to our character movement settings as well, such as the jump Z velocity and air control, etc. In this video, we're actually going to start working in the event graph and providing the functionality to handle when input is provided to drive our character in game. So setting up how the character actually moves. And to do that, inside of our character blueprint here still, we're going to hop over to the event graph. So if you have the character blueprint up, go ahead and hop to the event graph tab. If you don't have the character blueprint up, go ahead and inside your content browser, just double click the character blueprint folder. That should open it up and then hop to the event graph tab. Now this tab may look similar. You may have some nodes up here that are kind of grayed out. These nodes are here by default. We're not going to be using any of these. We're going to use our own. So I'm just going to right click and drag those off screen so that we have a nice big open area to work inside of our graph. Now before we start adding nodes, actually, I wanted to pop up our input settings that we did a couple videos ago. Actually, it's probably more than a couple videos ago now, but those input settings that we did inside of our project settings. So if I go back to the level editor viewport here and under edit and project settings, down under engine, there is our inputs. So these action mappings and access mappings, move forward, move right, etc. If I pop this off really quickly, like so, and bring this up so we can see it. What we're going to be doing is taking these move forwards, move right, all of these access mappings, and providing the nodes for those inside of our event graph here so that when these are called, when W is pressed, when S is pressed, then we can actually provide the functionality to move our character. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to close project settings. Just wanted to show that really quickly and remaximize our blueprint here. And the first one that we're actually going to add is the move forward. So go ahead and right click in the graph, in the search bar, go ahead and search for move forward. Now you can see we're presented with two options. We have the access event, and then we have access values. The access value will give us, as the name suggests, the value of our access move forward. So in essence, how much are we moving, where are we moving, etc. We actually want move forward the event. So when this event occurs, if you select it, then we can provide some script to tell the character how to move off of this wire here. So to do that, let's drag off this wire here, left click and drag, and let's search for add movement input. And there's two options here as well. We want the one under the input section here. These are the nodes that provide input from various sources, keyboards, mouse, etc. Go ahead and select the add movement input node. And once that node is added to the graph, you can see it's asking for a target, which is ourself, this blueprint. It's asking for a direction to face when moving. And then we have the scale value, which is the amount to move. There's also a force option, which we're not going to be dealing with too much. It says if true, add the input, ignoring the result of is move. Input ignored. We're not going to be using that, so don't worry about that. But these two we do want to worry about. Fortunately for us, the scale value is pretty easy. All we're going to do is take our access value here and connect that to the scale value. So just left click and drag and connect to the scale value like so. So we're getting the value of our movement, the length of our movement, and passing that into our scale value, the amount to move. For the direction, we have to do something a little bit different. We need to get the direction that the character is facing so that we know which direction to move. To do that, we're going to right click in the graph and we're going to search for get control rotation. There's not a G in rotation, I don't think. There we go. Get control rotation. You can see it's under the pawn setting here. So go ahead and select that. And it's going to give us a rotator here indicated by this lavender pin here. What we need to do is actually break that rotation because we only care about one aspect of rotation. If you recall, rotation includes pitch, yaw, and roll. We only really care about the yaw. So let's go ahead and break this rotation. So we can do that by dragging off here and releasing. And down at the very bottom, there is a break rot, which is short for rotation. Go ahead and select that. And you can see it gives us the pitch, yaw, and roll. And like I said, we only care about this yaw here. So let's drag off the yaw and let's now make rotation. So make rotation or make rot and go ahead and select that. And by default, it's connecting it to the pitch. We don't want that. So I'm gonna hold control down and drag this and plug it into the yaw like so. Kind of move these nodes over a little bit here just by left clicking to select all of them and then just moving them over just a little bit so they have a little bit more room. The next thing that we need to do is now that we have our yaw, what we need to do is get the forward vector, the way that we are facing. And let's go ahead and do that by dragging off the rotator here. And let's search for get forward vector. Like so. And that's going to give us our world direction. So let's move all this over just a little bit and connect it. So our move forward is set up. We now need to do the move right input axis. So let's go and do that. Let's right click and let's search for move right. Again, there's axis value and the axis event. Be sure to choose the axis event. So move right. And now that we have all of this information here, this process is actually going to be pretty easy. All I have to do is drag off of this rotator here and get the right vector. So we're going to drag off and release and search for get right vector. And once we have that, just like we did up here, we're going to add movement input. So I'm going to just copy this. So control C and control V. And let's plug that into the world direction. So. And let's connect the executable here, left click and drag, and plug that into the add movement input. And for the scale value, just as we did before, let's grab our axis value here and plug that into the scale value. So mouse wheeling down to zoom out a little bit here. Our movement is set up. We still need to account for mouse input and controlling the camera as well as jumping. But let's add a comment around this really quickly just to remember what all this does. Going to left click and drag a selection box around all of these and hit C to add a comment. And just going to type in movement. This is the movement script. Okay, two more things to do. Let's do our mouse input really quickly. So right clicking and dragging our move script out of the way so we have more room. Going to right click and search for turn. That's going to give us a couple options here. We have two axis events now. If you recall, we have turn and we have turn rate. Now the turn rate we're going to use for setting up the right gamepad, right thumbstick gamepad control for controlling the camera. For our mouse input, we actually want to use our turn event. So go ahead and select turn event. And let me mouse wheel in a little bit. And this is going to be super simple here. All we have to do for this one is just grab this axis value. Because whatever we are using for the direct access value from our mouse, whatever we do with our mouse, we want that to control the camera. So all we have to do is drag off access value and release and search for add controller yaw input. Like so. So that's going to give us direct left and right movement on our mouse, like my cursor is currently moving. So wherever we move the mouse, the camera is going to follow. Now we need to do the up and down, so we're going to get the pitch for that. So to do that, let's right click and let's search for, look up. So again, we have our look up and look up rate. The look up rate we'll be using for our right thumbstick control. But for the mouse, we're going to use the look up axis event here. So go ahead and select that. And just like we did with this above, we're going to drag off the axis value and search for add controller pitch input. So go ahead and select that. And now our mouse control is done. So let's add a comment around these. Left click, select them all, and hit C. And this is our mouse input. Now, the last thing that we need to do is add our jump. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm dragging over to the right here just a little bit. Let's right click and search for jump. And under input action events, there is our jump event that we created. So go ahead and select that. And it's giving us a pressed and released So when the button is pressed, we can do something. We can also do something when the button is released. We're only going to do pressed, so let's drag off of the pressed pin here. And fortunately for us, this one's going to be super simple. Just search for jump. Right there under pawn, under character, you see there's a function for jumping. Now this is one of the reasons that we chose to use character again as our parent class instead of pawn, as characters have the ability to use that character movement component, which includes things like jumping. So this makes it super simple for us. Let's go ahead and select jump, and you can see target is a character. And we are done. That is all we need to do for jump. So quick comment around those. Left click and drag and then hit C. And this is jump. So there we go. We are actually going to pause now in this video. We have created our movement, our WASD movement. Oh, I forgot to mention this actually. The move forward and move right access events here. Because we've set up our inputs to also account for gamepad controls with the left thumbstick and assign those under our move forward and move right. Again, if you want to see that really quickly, let's go to edit, project settings, input. Again, there's our move forward, and we also added our left thumbstick access here. And we did that for right as well, or for our X axis as well. These two settings, we don't have to do anything special for these. These are going to come by default whenever move forward and move right is called. So we don't have to set up any extra logic for controlling on keyboard versus thumbsticks. But for our turn rate, you can see we set those up a little bit differently. We have turn rate for our right thumbstick and lookup rate for our right thumbstick Y. And we use turn for our mouse control and lookup for our mouse control. So those are set up a little bit differently. So the left thumbstick is set up, but the right one we still need to set up. And we'll do that in another video here coming up here shortly. But that's going to wrap for this video. Back in our character blueprint, our character movement is set, our mouse control is set, and we can jump. We'll pause here, and in the next video, we will set up our game mode, which will allow us to assign a default playable character, which we can assign this blueprint. And then we'll test and we'll see if we can run around and jump in game. So let's pause here and we'll pick it up in the next video. Thank you guys for watching, and we will see you then.